So the reason that we're calling this survey a prioritization survey is because it's a tool we're using to find out what issues are the most important to our Listuguj community members. Again, as I mentioned, all of this information has been derived from the content of our workshops and our community meeting. So all of these topics have been discussed by our community members. Now we just need to figure out a way how we can rank them in priority. So there are 17 questions to our survey. And for our online viewers, question 18 is just an opportunity for you to fill out your name and contact number should you choose to participate in our draw. All completed surveys will be entered into a draw for a $200 Superstore gift card. And the closing of the survey is on the 27th of March, which I believe is next Monday. So on Tuesday, the 28th, we'll be holding the draw. So when we're looking at the survey, questions 1 to 4 are basic demographic questions, just to help us get a gauge of who is participating in the survey. Question 5 is a question on the Listuguj lobster fishing plan itself. So again, as mentioned in the presentation, this was an idea that was thought up from Chief and Council and the Listuguj Fisheries Department based on their interactions with DFO and based on their interactions with some of the fishermen on the water. But we really want to make sure that this is also something that the community members believe in. So question number 5 asks if you feel it's important for Listuguj to create our own plan, which is reflective of our needs and our rights, our Aboriginal rights, our inherent rights, and our treaty rights. And the answers there for you are yes, I agree. No, I feel the plan from DFO is sufficient, or you're just unsure. Question number 6 talks about how the LLFP should be ratified. So as mentioned, we're looking to show the community a draft copy of the fishing plan in and around the date of April 1st. And then around the date of April 22nd, we're hoping to show the final plan, which then would need to be ratified before we could put into action. So the options there would be a formal referendum. And that would mean that mail-out packages would be sent to every single Listuguj band member, whether you're on reserve or off reserve, and it would give them the opportunity to either vote by mail or vote in person. Option B is a community vote. So that's a little different because that's something that's organized at the community level where we pick a day, we set up polling stations, we have ballots available at the station, and community members must come to vote in person. You can request a ballot by mail if you're an off-reserve member, but your ballot must be received by the community date. So the difference here is there's no obligation to have to send out a formal referendum package. It's just advertised within the community, and we set up a date in the community for members to come and vote on the issue. Option C is that we just have Chief and Council decide on our behalf. So that would mean that the Fisheries Department and my team would give a presentation to Chief and Council based on our findings, and Chief and Council would make the decision at the table. And question D is a decision from Chief and Council, but with the support from either the Tribal Council or the Grand Council of the Mi'kmaq. So it would still be a political decision. However, they would need to secure the support from our traditional authority in our territory. Okay, so if we look at question 7 on our survey, it talks a lot about how the Listuguj lobster fishing plan should be managed. And again, from our discussion groups, there were some great ideas that were brought forward. So here are some of the options. Option A would be a Fishery Commission of Listuguj. And this commission would be responsible for approving policies, approving measures, and approving budgets for the Listuguj fishery operations. Members would include personnel from the LMG Fisheries Department, a representative from Chief and Council, a community elder, a community youth, and 2 persons with knowledge of Mi'kmaq cultural values and lobster fishing practices. So that commission would be really community-based, and they would be in charge of approving policies, measures, and budgets. Another suggestion was a Fisheries Authority of Listuguj, and they would be in charge of developing the policies. So actually sitting down and researching and writing the policies, developing measures, conducting research, and would be in charge of enforcing the policies. So members for this authority would include a personnel from the LMG Fisheries Department, representatives from other stakeholders, for example, GMRC, who might be doing some research, and the Listuguj Rangers, who might be involved in the enforcement, a community elder, and persons with knowledge of Mi'kmaq cultural values and fishing operations. Option C would be the LMG and chief and council only. So this would mean that the LMG Fisheries Department would be responsible for developing all policies, measures, and budgets, and the Listuguj chief and council would be in charge of approving all policies, measures, and budgets. There's also an option for a Listuguj Lobster Fishery Council to oversee the management of the LLFP and to work with the Fishery Commission or the Fishery Authority or LMG and Chief and Council just to make sure that the lobster fishing industry is properly represented. And of course, there's an option E if you have another suggestion that you think might work better than one of these. So in this question, again, as we mentioned, it's a prioritization survey. We're asking you to select your top two answers on how you would like to see the LLFP governed. In question 8, we talk a little bit about the role of the Listuguj Rangers and how they can be involved in the compliance and enforcement of the LLFP. Through our discussion groups, it was brought up several times how the Listuguj Rangers are here, we should be using them, and they can play a key role in the compliance and enforcement of a Listuguj lobster fishing plan. So you have options from A to J in this section, and we're asking you to please select all that apply. So option A talks about the rangers receiving specialized training in order to conduct spot checks on the vessels on the water to ensure they are following proper conservation measures. Option B talks about receiving specialized training in order to conduct spot checks on the vessels on the water to ensure that they were following proper safety measures. Option C is that the rangers should receive specialized training in order to review logbooks and data collection for Listuguj fishing vessels in order to ensure that captains are complying with all reporting requirements. Option D talks about the rangers receiving specialized training in order to confirm weigh scale amounts with the captains to confirm catch amounts for the Listuguj vessels. If you don't know, when vessels are docked at the wharf, one of the first things they do is weigh their catch right on the wharf so that they confirm how much they've actually fished out of the water. Option E is receive specialized training in order to respond to a distress call from a Listuguj fishing vessel. The Canadian Coast Guard can also do this. However, sometimes the Coast Guard vessels are quite a distance away from our fishing area, 21B. Option F is monitor that Listuguj fishing vessels remain within the specified area. G is monitor that the Listuguj fishing vessels are actively operated by Listuguj Mi'kmaq captains. B, monitor that all participants of the fall food fishery are Listuguj Mi'kmaq members. You could also, option I is none of the above, rangers should not be involved. And J, of course, gives you the opportunity to provide other suggestions on how the rangers could be involved in the compliance and enforcement of the Listuguj lobster fishing plan. So again, there are quite a few options there, and we're asking you to select all that apply. Question 9 talks a lot about Mi'kmaq customary practices. So we're asking you to identify your top 3 answers on which Mi'kmaq customary practices should be included in the practice of lobster fishing in Listuguj. So option A is a water ceremony to begin the season. B is a blessing of the boats to begin the season. C is a ceremony at the end of the season to give thanks. D is a community feast at the end of the season to give thanks and to celebrate. E is none, cultural practice are not necessary. Or F are other suggestions. So again, we're asking you to identify your top 3 answers there. So question 10 talks a lot about access for the commercial fishery. So as mentioned, our commercial boats fish out of a zone called 21B. And our fishermen have indicated to us, the information I've received through workshops, is that that zone is quite small. So in order to gain some more access for the members who wish to participate in the commercial fishery, we need to discuss some things with the Department of Fisheries and Oceans. So in the Listuguj Lobster Fishing Plan, we would like you to identify your top two ways in which you would like to see Listuguj Mi'kmaq fishermen gain more access. And this will be information that the Fisheries Department and Chief and Council can use when they're in negotiations with the Department of Fisheries and Oceans. So how would you like to see the Listuguj Lobster fishing community gain more access to the lobster? Please select your top two answers. Option A, increase the number of licenses used in our current fishing zone, Area 21B. So as discussed, we currently have 4. So if you select option A, you're saying you would like to see more than 4 licenses, but still in the zone of 21B. Option B, increase the size of our fishing zone and then increase the number of licenses. So if you're selecting B, you're saying we need to make our zone bigger than what is currently 21B, and then we can add more licenses once we get more space on the water. Option C is rotate fishing zones on an annual basis to give our fishermen and fisherwomen access to other more plentiful zones in the region. So this was an idea that came from one of our workshops where it may be possible to rotate zones on an annual basis. So 1 year we fish out of 21B, the next one we fish out of 21, the next year we fish out of 22, and we come back and we use that rotation. The idea is that perhaps some of these zones are bigger and more plentiful with lobster, so it gives our fishermen and women the ability to generate a little bit more income for themselves from those different zones. Option D is to rotate the licenses amongst Listuguj fishermen and women on a yearly basis so that our 4 licenses can be accessed by several boats. This does mean, however, that not every boat will have the opportunity to operate in every season. So say, for example, if we have 6 boats, the first year boat 1 to 4 can operate, the next year boat 3 to 6 can operate, the next year it'll be a different 4. So every year somebody's got to sit out, but at least the licenses get rotated between all members who express an interest to be a part of the commercial lobster fishery. Option E is we do not need more access. Our 4 licenses and the access to Area 21B are sufficient. So if you feel that no change is necessary, you can select option E. Or option F is other suggestions if you have another idea on how we can gain more access to the lobster. For question 11, it talks about increasing the value of lobster for our commercial lobster fishery. So one of the things that we're looking to do with the plan is to figure out a way we can increase the value of an individual lobster. That way we can gain higher profit margins for our fishermen. So there are a few options here, and the question is, how can we increase the value of our product, which is the lobster that's harvested by Listuguj commercial fishermen, in a sustainable way? Please select your top 2 answers. So you could select A, acquire eco-certification for our product. And eco-certification provides the purchaser with information regarding where, when, how, and whom the lobster is harvested. And we see this a lot in the food market, especially with organic food. Keeping that chain of custody can add value to the food if you know that it was handled and cared for and grown in a good way. So it's the same idea that we would apply to our lobster fishing. Option B is traceability. So this means that we would tag lobsters in zone 21B with barcode devices. When barcode devices are scanned, a photo or a media file will pop up and will provide some information to the purchaser about Listuguj lobster, Mi'kmaq culture, Listuguj geography, the path of travel of the lobster. There's lots of different options, but basically it would increase the value of the lobster by providing more information and by providing a cool technical file that's kind of attached, tells a story about the lobster. Option C is marketing. So we could create a marketing strategy for our brand that is associated with the lobster harvested by Listuguj fishermen and women. This marketing strategy could include visual arts, media arts, documentaries, literature, logo development, any other ideas that would involve marketing ourselves as being a leader in the lobster fishing industry. Or option D is take no action. We did not need to increase the value of the lobster. Fisheries is prosperous enough. For question 12, we're talking about how we can create additional business opportunities for our local fishermen and women. So one of the ideas that was brought up during our workshops was to create a fish market or a lobster shack in Listuguj that could be used during the commercial and or the food fishery, where fishermen and women could sell a portion of their catch to the lobster shack, and then the lobster shack could sell their products to the Listuguj community and surrounding members. So do you support the idea of a lobster shack or fish market in Listuguj? Option A, yes, as an additional opportunity for Listuguj fishermen and women, but only during the commercial season. Option B, yes, as an additional business opportunity for Listuguj fishermen and women for both the commercial and the fall food fishery season. Or no, I do not support the idea of a lobster shack in Listuguj. Okay, and question 13, we are discussing the distribution of tags during the fall food fishery season. So if you remember back to our presentation, we talked about how during the fall food fishery season, Listuguj receives one license, and that license is broken down into 500 individual tags. The reason that Listuguj has a fall fishery is that First Nations people have successfully made the argument that they deserve more access to the lobster fishery than just the commercial season, because culturally, lobster has been a way that we have sustained ourselves since time immemorial. So for the fall food fishery season, only First Nations fishermen and women are allowed to be on the water. There are no fishing boats out there that are not license holders from a First Nations community. And the intent for the fall fishery is to feed the community members. From DFO standpoint, there are not supposed to be any commercial sales from the fall food fishery. It's all meant to feed the community, to share amongst each other, and to for a way to be able to sustain ourselves. So when we talk about the tags, the Listuguj Mi'kmaq Government Fisheries Department does own one lobster fishing boat, and they staff that lobster fishing boat every fall food fishery. And they have the capacity to handle about 100 of those tags. So right off the top, 100 tags are given to the LMG fishing boat. So that begs the question on how do we distribute the remaining 400 tags? And through our workshops, there have been lots of discussion on this topic, and a few really good ideas emerged from those discussions. So option A, we're asking you to select one answer here. Option A would be remaining tags evenly divided among large and small boats who identify they want to participate in the fall food fishery. So this means that the large boats, the ones who would usually participate in the commercial fishery, and smaller boats, so just private fishermen or women, they would need to identify to the fisheries department that they do intend on fishing in the fall food fishery season. And then the fisheries department would evenly divide the tags amongst them. So for example, if 6 boats come forward, large or small, then they would each receive approximately 66 tags to be fished. And each of those 6 boats would agree to donate a certain percentage of their catch back to the community so that it can be distributed through our general food distribution process. So that's option A. Any boat, large or small, if you identify you want to participate in the food fishery, we'll split the tags up evenly against you, and you must donate a percentage of your catch back for community members. We do understand that it's a cost. You know, you have to go out, you fuel your boat, you buy your bait, you need to pay yourself. Of course, we're not expecting 100% to be donated back, but there will need to be a portion agreed on and that portion will be the same for all boats involved. So option B is a little bit different. So option B says, after LMG gets their 100 tags, what we should do is offer tags to fishermen and women on small boats and then divide the remaining tags among the large identified boats. So this is a little different because sometimes a private fisher person, a person who owns a small boat or scow, may not necessarily want to participate in the fall food fishery, but they just want to be able to go out and fish for themselves and be able to provide for their family. So this allows them to come forward and identify that they want to be able to fish for themselves and their family. They'll receive one tag for themselves, and they'll receive a tag for their dependents. So that would mean their children, their spouse, their elderly parents. So if I'm a fisher person who wants to go and fish and just to feed my family, I could receive a tag for me, a tag for my two kids, for my two parents, and my spouse. So that would be six tags, for an example. I would go out, I would fish, and it would be my responsibility to share the catch with my family. So any family member who agrees to allocate their tag to me would not be able to participate in the general fall food fisher distribution. So you know how everyone lines up at the bingo hall to get their bag of cooked lobster. If a family member donated their tag to a fisher person, they would not be able to participate in that line. But it does give fisher people an opportunity to just go out and kind of fish for themselves and fish for their families. So after that distribution process is handed out, whatever tags are remaining, probably between 300 and 350, those tags would be divided amongst the large fishing boats. So the boats who usually go out during the commercial season, they're fairly large. And those captains could identify that they want to participate in the fall fishery. Tags would be evenly divided. They would go out and fish and donate the same percentage back. So it's very similar to option A, except we're adding in that additional step where small boats can take tags for themselves and their family members, and then the rest of the tags get divided on the large boats who are going to go out, fish for the community, and donate a percentage back. Option C, of course, is do not change the system at all. So the way the system works now, the LMG boat takes 100 tags. Then a notice is put up that community members can come and pick up a tag for themselves. So between the hours of 10 and 3 at the Natural Resources Building on Saturday, May 1st, you can go, or Saturday, September 1st, you can go and pick up a tag. You would have to identify to the Fisheries Department if you intend to fish for yourself or if you're going to give your tag to a fisherman to fish for you. And then your name would be crossed off the list for the general food fishery distribution. So meaning you wouldn't be able to go stand in line at the bingo hall and receive any cooked lobster. After this process is done, there usually are some tags left because not everybody comes to pick up a tag. So what happens, there's an impromptu meeting with the LMG Fisheries Department and the local fishermen and women, and they decide on the spot how those tags should be handed out, the remaining tags, and what the contribution should be back to the community. Through our discussion, there were some concerns raised about this current system. A large majority of community members were uncomfortable with the fact that this system did increase the chance of tags being sold for money instead of being given to a fisherman for a lobster. So that's just a little note for you to keep in mind that that's currently the process in Listuguj now. If you're fine with that, you can select option C. If you would like to see something done a different way, then you can choose between option A or option B. For question 14, now we talk about the actual process of distribution for the cooked lobster. So what happens now is the boats come in, the lobster's weighed, the agreed percentage is taken and sent to the Listuguj Fisheries Department. There's usually some cooks there waiting. They cook up the lobster, boil it. They send out a notice letting people know when they can pick up cooked lobster. People form a line. You go. You identify yourself. They double check you on the Listuguj ban list, you know, so just to make sure that you're a member, and you can pick up your lobster. So each bag contains the same amount of lobster. Sometimes it's two. Sometimes it's three. You must be 18 years of age or older to stand in the line, and you can only receive lobster once a day. You can go all 21 days and stand in line if you want, but you're only allowed to receive one parcel per day. Oftentimes, deliveries are made to elders at their residence. And if they're home, they can receive a parcel. If not, usually a little notice has been left on their door letting them know that somebody at least stopped by. So through our discussion, there has been lots of suggestions on how we could alter or change or improve upon the system. So question 14, we're asking you to select your top three answers. And option A is allow for members to pick up live lobster so they can cook and prepare the lobster themselves. Option B is allow members with children under the age of 18 to receive additional lobster. So this is based on the premise that people with larger families may need more lobster to be able to feed their entire family. Option C is allow members to reserve lobster parcels by phone when it is not possible for them to leave work. And a great example of this came from our teachers who said, you know, if the distribution line is at 3 o'clock, we've got to stay with our students until school is dismissed. So we can't just leave work and go and pick up some lobster. So the suggestion was maybe have some kind of telephone reservation system. Option D is, you know, alter or change the cooking methods. So the amount of salt used, the number of water changes per boil, making sure that there's no elastic bands left on the lobster. Option E is more staff required to both speed up the cooking time and to make the actual distribution process a little bit more efficient. And option F, of course, is other suggestions. So if there's something that you can think of that we have yet to discuss, please indicate it there and we'll take it into consideration. Question 15 talks about research. So currently, there is no research team specific to Listuguj. Any research regarding lobster fisheries, lobster habitats, lobster health, were coming from outside sources, mostly from the Department of Fisheries and Oceans. And as mentioned, the data that they use to calculate their effort-based formula is quite outdated. So in the Listuguj Lobster Fishing Plan, the thought was that we should build a component on how we can conduct our own research on our own waters from our own people. So question 15 asks, what areas of research would you like to see included in the LLFP? Please select all that apply. So option A, lobster populations and reproductivity. Option B, lobster habitats in the Baie de Chaleur. Option C, industrial impacts on lobster ecosystems. D, environmental impacts on lobster ecosystems. E, health and current state of local water systems. As we know, if we have unhealthy water, we have unhealthy marine life. Option F, none, we can rely on the DFO data. Or G, other suggestions. So please indicate all those areas which you feel Listuguj should kind of start to take charge and do our own research in. Question 16 talks about conservation and restoration measures. And there have been some that have been suggested for the LLFP. It is important to note that options A to C already do comply with DFO regulations, but through our workshops, there were some more ideas generated on what we can do to kind of help and protect our ecosystems and our lobster habitats as well. So please indicate which measures you would support. Please select all that apply. Option A is V notching, which is voluntary marking of egg-bearing females to ensure they are not harvested. So we don't want to catch any pregnant female lobsters. B, exit holes and traps to allow small lobsters to escape. Now this does exist, but there is always the conversation on how large or small those holes should be and if they should be mandatory. C, limiting maximum catch sizes based on available ecological data. So calculating how much lobster we should take based on the current population and health of the lobster in the water. D, seeding projects to help increase lobster populations. E, the creation of artificial reefs to improve lobster habitat. F, none of the above. I am not concerned with lobster conservation or restoration. And of course, G allows you to provide a suggestion that may not be listed here. So again, we're asking you to indicate all that apply any of these conservation measures you would support in the Listuguj lobster fishing plan. And our last question deals with the trying to create community attachment between Listuguj community members and the practice of lobster fishing in our community. So the practice of lobster fishing is integral to our Mi'kmaq culture, our inherent rights, and our Aboriginal and treaty rights. What methods should the LLFP incorporate to help create a stronger sense of support and community attachment between Listuguj members and the practice of lobster fishing? So here there's quite a few suggestions, and we're asking you to indicate your top five answers. So option A, large community celebrations, for example, community feasts. Emphasis on Mi'kmaq language when talking about lobster. Create a social media campaign to promote and educate members during lobster fishing season. Provide cultural teaching sessions during lobster fishing season. Introduce lobster and lobster habitat lessons at AGS, that's Alaksido Gipu School, our local school here in Listuguj. Create a logo contest for the lobster fishery. Create various teaching tools such as documentaries, storybooks, songs to be used within Listuguj. Offer tours on Listuguj fishing boats. Create fundraising opportunities, for example, lobster cookbooks or a recipe contest. Or other suggestions. So if you have a great idea that's not already on our list, please feel free to add it and make sure you indicate your top five answers. So that sums us up for our prioritization survey. And again, it's just a reminder that all this information was derived from our community engagement sessions. And now this is a chance for community members to tell us what is most important to them. I'm sure you'll agree that a lot of these items are really, really great ideas, but if we had to choose, which would be your top priorities? So again, I thank you for listening. You can always contact me, Dawn Germain, at lobster@listuguj.ca, or you can call the Natural Resources, which is 418-788-3022. If you have any questions about the survey or the engagement process, please feel free to contact me. Otherwise, I really appreciate your participation in the survey. And if you're available on Thursday night, March 23rd, I hope to see you at our dinner party. Wallalio.